everyone, I'm Wygo Warrior, aka Julie. Welcome back to my channel. If you've stopped by because you've always been curious about Uoma Beauty, then stick around because I did a haul. I'm going to unbox it and throw it on my face. So back in May, I saw a sale, got a text, I don't know. Certain brands I've never tried before, I know about them because of the YouTube beauty space. I'm always curious. Love a good sale, yada yada. Long story short, I made a haul. Well, it arrived a while ago. It's just been sitting waiting to be unboxed and filmed. If you aren't aware, I have done some epic organization videos, which has taken a lot of my time. So it's time to try some new makeup. Leave me a comment and let me know if you have tried this brand before. And if so, what are your thoughts? This will be a first impression, if I can ever get the box undone. I was surprised at how small this box is. I don't remember everything I got, but I thought I got enough to put together a look. Obviously, I don't think I got eyeshadow because this box is too small. Let me come back after I get the tape off this. Okay, that took way more effort than I thought. This is what it looks like inside. We got some red tissue paper. It had the purchase order on top. We got some stickers. Those are cool. All right, I come to you with a bare face other than top lashes only, one coat of mascara. I can't remember what I got. Hopefully I got some foundation or something to put on my face. Yes! Okay, first I randomly took out of the tissue paper. This is the Say What? Weightless Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation. Thank goodness. What shade is this in? Oh, it says Shake Well Before Use. I have the shade. Oh, here there it is. Fair Lady TN1. I'm the worst shopping online. All right, well, that looks pretty good. The glass is frosted. I bet it's going to be a little lighter. Only one way to find out. Oh, yeah, it said shake well. By the way, this is a glass bottle. It has a lovely pump. Let's do a little swatch. Ooh. My ooh was when it came out in a big glob. It looked a little dark. The lighting in here is kind of washing out. There you go. I will make this work. All right, what else did I get? What is this? Okay, this is Double Take, and it's a Sculpt and Strobe stick in the shade Fair Lady. Oh, what is strobe? Is it gonna be contour one end, highlighter the other? All right, so this is what she looks like. And yes. Contour one end, highlighter on the other. That is, let's do a swatch. A little dark. They call this fair? Wait, what? Oh, shopping online. So much fun. All right, so here is the highlighter. Here is the contour. Let's, before I judge it, rub it out. It seems for fair, a little dark. Yes, so I will have to go in very light-handed. Interesting. I'm wondering if I should put that on underneath the foundation. I've never tried that before. Maybe today's the day. All right, what else did I get? What do we have here? This is Prime to Glow Skin Perfecting Illuminating Primer. All right, yes, I need all the help I can get. Oh, this video, I'm super excited. Now, the shades aren't the best match, but nothing I can do about it. All right, chugging along. Next item, what do we have here? This, I believe, is an eyeliner. Yes, black eyeliner, blacker than y'all. I am not from the South, and I feel like I just offended anyone who is from the South. That was the worst y'all ever. All right, so here is the eyeliner. Does not have a roller ball. I don't know why. I love roller balls. Seems to have a felt tip. Let's do a swatch and see if it's matte or shiny. And then I'll give it a few minutes and do my smudge test. All right, next item. This here is Woke. Stay Woke. It's a brightening concealer in the shade White Pearl T2. Now the foundation was T1, was a tad dark. Let's see what T2 looks like. Don't know till we swatch. Holy schmoly. That is a huge doe foot, particularly for the size of the bottle. It's like half the size or one third. That's insane. This is quite dark as well. My lighting makes it wash out. In real life, trust me, it's a little dark, but I will make it work. All right, and the last item is this one here, which on the front it says a little bit of this and a little bit of that, but it's actually called the It's Complicated, which, get this, is a lip tint plus oil plus gloss. That's what it says on the packaging, but on the paperwork it says it is a lip tint plus cheek stain plus oil plus gloss. That's a lot. So basically lips and cheek. So hopefully it's not dry on the lips because it works on my cheeks, or glossy on the lips, and you get me. Let's do a swatch of this. Interesting. All right, so it has a flat paddle applicator. I'm trying to figure out if it's purple. I think the doe foot is purple, and then this is kind of a mauve-y, purpley brown. All right, only one way. Let's swatch. Oh, that's lovely for the lips. It feels very wet, like a lip oil, which my lips will enjoy. Let's throw some on now. Does it have a scent? Zero scent. No fruity, no sweet, no chemical, no makeup scent. Like nothing. Feels very cooling on the lips. Comfortable. Very wet, as a lip gloss or lip oil would feel. I don't know how it's gonna do on the cheeks, but we shall see. All right, time for the try-on portion. Oh, I forgot. Let's test out the eyeliner. Whoa, that works really good. I wiped off the swatches. I don't know if it'll pick up. That lip stain did what it said. It stained my hand a little bit. All right, full disclosure. I had started filming the try-on portion, got halfway through, when I looked up and noticed my battery had died. So I didn't want to take off everything, start over. I had other stuff to film. So I completed my makeup look, filmed those other videos, and decided I would return to this video today. So this is the next day. Hopefully I'm replicating what I'd filmed yesterday. I think I just had one top coat of mascara and I tried the lip product. So my hair may look slightly different. The lighting may be slightly different, but just know, stuff happens, so I'm going to continue on. All right, let's start with applying the primer. This was safety sealed. I took it off yesterday. It's a interesting kind of a soft peachy shade, which doesn't put color on your face per se, but interesting that it's not like bright white or green or anything like that. All right, let's get it going. Lovely glow. Ignore the redness. That's just from me smushing my hands on my face. It's giving me some Wet n Wild vibes in a good way. All right, on to foundation. I already know this shade is too dark for me. So I'm going to add, I gotta leave the house today. Yesterday I didn't, but today I do. I have a BB cream that is way too light for me. I use it often to mix with products that are too dark. This is all I do. And if you haven't done this yet, I strongly recommend. If you ever get a product that's way too light, way too dark, hang on to it, because you can use it to mix in with other products and get the perfect shade. Got is advertised as neutral. Keep that in mind if you're shopping for an Uoma foundation. All right, now for concealer, which also is a little dark, but we're just gonna go with it. The foundation didn't stick to the top of my nose, so I'm gonna add some foundation here. You can see how dark that concealer is. You can barely see it because it's matching with the darkness of the foundation. That's on me, my shopping errors. But if I can find some photos, I want to show you what they advertise on their website versus what it's looking like in reality. Now, the foundation is as advertised, in my opinion. It's a very high, medium, and or low full coverage. Look how it's doing with my hyperpigmentation. You can still slightly see it, but nothing compared to when I'm not wearing foundation. So that point of the product is accurate. All right, now for the scary bit. This definitely was a shopping error. Again, if I can find a photo, I want to show the description and how this looks on their website. This is number 3. It is called Fair Lady. I'm a fair lady, but I would say this is for medium skin tone folks, but I'm going to make it work. I'm just going to take a brush and barely touch it and go like this. Touch. Definitely shop a softer shade than I got if you are fair like me. All right, let's try the other end of the stick, which they advertise as a strobe. I'm gonna refer to it as a highlighter. I thought it was gonna be too dark, which it is, but then it isn't because this foundation is so dark. Maybe in editing I'll notice it. In real life, it's like, I don't see it. All right, it's on. In a non-scary way, I'm not seeing it because I thought this would be full on way too dark, which it is, but so is the foundation. All right, moving along to this scary product here. Not scary on the lips. I'm a little scared to put on my cheeks, but it's advertised as lip and cheek. So let's see how it does right here. It looks okay. I do not like how it feels. It's sticky, tacky on the cheeks, not on the lips, but it's different than other kind of cream multitasking products that tend to be more for the cheek and a little drying on the lips. This definitely is like a lip stain, lip gloss consistency, so it's great on the lips. I'm not digging it on the cheeks. The color and tone is very subtle. That part I do, but it's tacky. All right, I'm gonna put together an eye look and then come back and try on the eyeliner. All right, I am back with some eyeshadow. I just need to complete my entire eye look with trying out the liquid eyeliner. Alright, I have not applied more of the lip product. I just wanted to check in to let you know there's just a little bit of slip left. It's been on my face maybe 20 minutes. It is doing a good job of staining, but the initial kind of glossiness has already gone away. I don't know if it will pick up on camera, but these three fingers are stained versus this one not, because those were the fingers I used to apply it as a cheek product. I do not recommend using this on your cheeks. Well, have at it, do as you please. This to me 100% is definitely a lip stain or lip oil, more so than any of the claims that they say this lip product is about, or that this product is for your cheeks. No, this is for your lips, in my opinion. Some of it has to do with the products, some of it has to do with my shopping ability and or how they display and advertise the shades of products on their website. So, the black eyeliner. I do not care for the tip. It is very thin, but very stiff. I normally never struggle to apply liquid eyeliner. I was struggling a little bit. It was just not dragging very well. It kind of skipped. It's very waterproof, but that's the scary part, if something skips, because if you mess up, it's on there unless you grab like a Q-tip and a product specifically to remove it, and then you just messed up your eye look. So for me, no, sorry Sharon, this product here, shopping error and or website combination error. I could make this really dark contour bronzer work very light hand. The strobe or highlighter, I'm not seeing it. Where is it? It disappeared. So careful on the shade you purchase. Again, shopping error, shade issue on the website. This seems very drying to me, and it was kind of touted as hydrating. Not my favorite, but because it's so dark, sometimes I end up with something that's way too light, so I can mix the two. The foundation. If you like high medium to a fuller coverage, I think you'll enjoy this. It is touted, or the shade I got is Fair Lady T1N. And it stands for neutral. I do not find this to be neutral at all. It has a very strong yellow undertone. So if you're fair like me, be forewarned, go down a shade or two. I will, during editing, I'm going to go back to the website to find out how much of this was I'm a bad shopper versus, what they advertise and what they show for swatches and the lady wearing it. If they need some improvement there. Jury's out, but how can so many of these products I picked up be so wrong? But to be fair, it could be me, and I'll be the first to go, screwed up. But something will float on screen during editing. The primer. Because this is more full coverage, I don't know if any of the glowiness is shining through. Oh, it is a little bit. Yes, so to me, this is one of the best products I tried on today, because I love a glowy primer. Now, I don't remember how much this retails for. I have a product that I enjoy even more from Wet n Wild, and it's probably a lot more affordable. But this one, if you pick it up, or I don't even know why I bought a primer. Maybe it was a free gift with purchase, but regardless, I did enjoy this primer. Who am I? Because usually I'm like, primer. Now I did notice on the back of their packaging, They have steps. So foundation is one, concealer is two, and the multi contour strobe stick is number three. So without me knowing it, I picked up the first three steps. So yay me. All right, let me know your thoughts. Too dark? And keep in mind, I got some bright lights on me. Have you tried Uoma Beauty products before? Did you shop online like I did and maybe get something way too dark? Or no, Julie, you're just really bad at shopping, because that could be the case. I want to hear from you. I want to know your thoughts on this brand and these products. If anyone's interested, I'm going to list on the screen what I spent, what the MSRP versus the sale I took advantage of. So if you have been interested in this brand or any other brand, I strongly recommend you wait for a sale. There's going to be a lot going on for the 4th of July, and just it's summertime. So I'm noticing there's been a lot of sales. Or if you just like shopping whenever, go for it. All right, I want to thank each and every one of you for stopping by. I really do appreciate it. If you haven't done so by now, I would love if you would subscribe. For those who have, thank you so much. Remember to click that bell icon so you can be notified of future videos. And if you could do me a huge favor and click that thumbs up, it really does help with my channel to grow. All right, thanks everyone.